the cayenne coffee.
Nice.
And Noel explained the ingredients and the inspiration behind this drink.
Yeah, so with the peppermint, we wanted to balance it out with something warm to complement the cayenne notes. So we have a base of espresso. And then equal parts Irish cream and Kahlua to add some sweetness and creaminess. Added a touch of Rumpelmann's for some more peppermint flavor. And then we put frothed milk on top just to add to the creaminess, make it more of a latte. And then we rimmed the glass with simple syrup and crushed up candy cane. We also have crushed up candy cane in the coffee, if you forgot to mention that.
That's right, and a little bit of cayenne, too, so the final just gives you a little warmth in the throat.
Yep, and then we just sprinkled on a dusting of cayenne on the top. Yes. Enjoy. All Enjoy right. it right now.
All right, you guys film me.
While it's still warm.
Okay. This looks so good.
So.
Oh, okay. Woo!
What, can I try it?
It's so good. So I get all the notes, the creaminess, the sweetness, the heat, but not too much because I was a little nervous about that when you were sprinkling it on. The mint is really pronounced along the rim, and I like to be able to like crunch a little bit at the end of my drink. Well done. All right, so today we made a spicy Santa for you. I'm going to explain what it is.
So we started off with a vodka base, and then we added the Kahlua, and the cayenne is in the drink as well. And crushed peppermint was blended in with ice so that it has a nice, smooth...
Minty
texture.
Okay.
And then Megan made this whipped cream with peppermint extract and peppermint crumbs, and then it is sprinkled with cayenne on the top and peppermint crumbs on the top.
Oh.
So you have to try the whipped cream.
Okay. All right. So this is our spicy Christmas Kahlua. And we made ice cream in a bag, a milkshake with that was Kahlua coffee flavored as well as peppermint. And then we did a cayenne spicy chocolate drizzle around it. And there's a little bit of that hot fudge, spicy hot fudge inside. And then a spicy chocolate rim with candy canes on top.
Oh, okay.
It's both a milkshake and... To get the spicy, we put a spoon in there so you could get that chocolate.
Okay, so I should probably do it with a spoon like this. Oh.
Some of that chocolate. Nice.
Oh my gosh. I'm gonna try a little bit more. I'm getting everything but the heat.
Wait for it.
Yeah, it's in the chocolate, so it should...
I took too big of a chocolate bite.
The chocolate sure hit us afterwards.
Oh, man, I can feel that rolling. You really got a good ice cream consistency, like milkshake, which is really fun and creative. There comes the heat. Yep. Just took a little longer than the other ones, which is kind of nice. Really good. I can't taste maybe the Kahlua quite as much, like that coffee flavor, but it's more of chocolatey mint. But I like the heat. Yep, I'm feeling the heat. Okay, let's pass it around. Yeah. Yummy, yum.
Pad we tried.
Clever.
Yes, and so what we have here is this is a throwback recipe from camping in the backcountry of a pad Thai recipe that's has a mushroom garlic saute blended in and topped off with this amazing sriracha mayo potato chip. Garnish, or what would
sauce.
You call this? A sauce on it, puree on the top, great. Garnished with some cilantro and crushed chips to give it that extra little salty vinegar punch.
Yep. Is there noodles or something in there?
Oh, yeah. So the noodles, it's a ramen noodle. Mm. Start with a ramen noodle. Okay. And peanut butter, obviously.
Yes.
Has the peanut butter.
Okay. In the sauté.
The garlic, the mushrooms, and the let's see, the... Wait, where was the peanut butter again? Yeah, the peanut butter's in the sauce.
It was in the sauce.
In the noodles. Sauce. And okay. Then the mushrooms and the garlic were sautéed and incorporated into the noodles.
Okay.
Interesting.
We should get some sauce.
Mom space.
It's so good, right?
Yeah, it's like that face is just like so complex.
You know, what happened is that...
What happened?
The noodles got really mushy.
Oh!
So the ingredient that you didn't even, like, care, you know, like, wasn't part of it is kind of taking it down a notch here. But let me get some more of the sauce, because this could be... Let me just try this.
Try it. Want to try it.
Okay, one more bite. I like the chips.
This is why we call it the pad we tried. We're getting ahead of it.
That was a good. So these are our Asian inspired nachos. And Megan will tell you everything that's in them.
Okay. So we have this special little Asian soy peanut sauce that we like to make. It has like honey and ginger and rice vinegar. So we thought that would go really well with the salt and vinegar chips. So we made that and sauteed some mushrooms to make a nice little almost like a dip. So we wanted something that would be, like, easy to share as, like, an appetizer. So we have a nice little bite. And, yeah, we garnished it with some cilantro. All
right.
Hopefully you like it. All right. This is our dish called Pasta Paradise. And it is a peanut butter pasta with a onion, mushroom, garlic sauce. And...
Cream sauce.
And it is on a bed of spinach. And it is topped with buttered and broiled salt and vinegar potato chips. So they're extra crunchy and have a little bit more flavor to them. And then chopped peanuts as well.
Wow.
Our dessert called Cheese Louise. Where is the cheese?
Oh. So,
this is based off of an apple crisp kind of recipe. So you have caramelized apples with brown sugar and maple syrup.
Bourbon, yeah, the bourbon infused maple syrup.
And we also have a little bit of butterscotch schnapps incorporated into the apples. We also have three layers of oats, which are also caramelized in brown sugar, butter, and
cinnamon and
syrup. And then we have a Velveeta infused cream cheese with some powdered sugar and some other stuff. And our goal is to kind of not mask the cheese, but have it be in there a little bit. So, geez Louise, where's the cheese? So, bon appetit.
Thank you.
Oh, and then we have whipped cream on top.
Oh,
and with
that.
Some nutmeg.
With nutmeg.
And some
nutmeg. Oh my gosh, let's see if all this works together.
That's so good.
Yeah! Do you taste any Velveeta at all?
Well, Grace, it tastes different than just a regular apple crisp. So, like, there's some creaminess.
Well, it's not the cream cheese. And I think the Velveeta kind of blends in with the cream cheese.
Yeah.
So it just tastes like
a
little bit more savory cream cheese.
Kind of that's a good way to say it. It's kind of like a savory.
All the flavors work nice. I like the warmth.
We would have done ice cream a la mode if we had any. How are the oats?
Yeah, I'm gonna just go right into the crumble here.
We put it.
Here, we'll practice with this.
Crap load of sugar and syrup and butter.
Very sweet.
Yeah.
But I love it.
And action. Bold.
So this is our special spiced apple custard.
Nice. So we have a little custard base, which incorporates the Velveeta. And then we have the apples are glazed in the, bourbon-infused maple syrup with cinnamon and nutmeg. And then we have
clove.
Okay.
And then we also have a nice streusel on top, and then it is garnished with whipped cream, donated from the other team, and a caramel drizzle.
Nice.
We have not tried it all together yet.
Did you say a name?
Yes, spiced apple custard. We have not tried it all together, so...
All right. We'll see.
Alright, I like the little cute little shape of it.
Yeah, it's still
don't want to eat the.
Don't eat the paper. But eat the paper.
Eat the paper.
Let's see.
If it's on the plate, you have to eat it. That's the rules.
Everything works well.
Thank you, Chef.
Alright, this is our. No bake, no name cookie. So it is a chocolate no bake cookie that has the Velveeta incorporated in it. It gives it a more shiny texture. I don't know if that's right.
Appearance.
And then we have the bourbon infused maple syrup and the apples sauteed together, I guess.
Okay.
And then we garnished it with some raspberry. Oh, I forgot to mention there is a layer of raspberry jam on there. And then we have some raspberry whipped cream to go along with it. And it is garnished with some raspberries and star-shaped apples.
Apple stars. All right. So when you go at this,
yes.
you can bite it like a cookie.
Oh, okay.
But you can use the fork to add a little bit of that whipped cream on top.
This is very interesting. Like that?
Yep.
It just takes a while for all the flavors to kind of release. That's really good. Very different approach than the other one, so well done for creativity. I can't taste the cheese.
That's good.
I like that raspberry isn't overpowering, which I kind of worried about. Nice texture, like a chewy cookie texture.
Wait, whose is that? Is it theirs?
Yeah, it's theirs. Oh, I maybe tasted raspberry a little more than the apple.
Really?
Let me get one more bite. So, I really like that.
Is that a bad thing if you taste raspberry?
No, but I want to taste the apple too.
Mm-hmm.
They're pretty balanced.
That's good.
All right, try it.